that Christ was born. Thank you.
Welcome to our Christmas presentation, the greatest gift of all. The greatest gift given long ago wasn't wrapped in paper or tied with a bow. God's only Son from heaven above, given to us straight from His love. Lest we forget, please hold on tight to the great truths brought on that night. His gift of love for all to receive, the gift of salvation to those who believe.
Thank you. FYU.
It's hard to sing those songs with those masks on. I'm going to say a few things. I'm going to turn it over to Sister Solitaire. Amen. She don't know, but she's going to come up and do this with these gifts and stuff. Amen. Thank you all for being here today. We are celebrating Christmas. I know Christmas is not till later on this week, but we just want to say Merry Christmas to all of you. Merry Christmas to all our viewers, those that are watching us live, and we just... every opportunity we get to come into the house of God is truly a blessing. We said we was going to give away some gifts, some prizes. If you don't have a raffle ticket, you might want to get one. Amen. Raise your hand if you don't have a raffle ticket. We got some hands. Amen. Amen. Very quickly, very quickly. Amen. We got about 5 minutes to do this. Y'all know I'm timely. Amen. While they're getting the tickets out, amen, for those that are watching live, you should see something on our page to say, to like, to share, to comment. That's how you get your name into the online bucket where we'll pull your name. It's on there somewhere on the page, the Great Love page, in the comment section for those that are watching us live. It's giving time. While they're doing that, we'll go ahead and take care of the giving. Amen. For those that desire to give by way of Cash App, Greater Love, the number one. Amen. You can go to our website, greaterlovefriscocity.com, and give through PayPal. We thank you for your continuous gifts, your seeds, continue to be sown into the kingdom. Amen. Come on, Sister Solitaire. Let us pray. Oh, gracious God, we thank you for the gift. We thank you for the giver. God, we ask that you would bless it. God, we ask, oh God, that you will continue to allow us to give cheerfully with a cheerful heart. Thank you for, Lord God, that for the abundance, the overflow that you continue to pour into this ministry and allow us, oh God, to be about kingdom business. So God, we tell you thank you in advance for what you're going to do. In Jesus' name, amen. Anybody ready for some gifts? Amen. Any, I don't want to say lucky, but any blessed folks in the house? Amen. Who's that in the back?
Nothing you can do about it.
sister. Bless you. Father, we thank you for the precious gift in the form of Jesus. Father God, we thank you how he came to live and to die for our sins. Thank you for that gift. Now, God, we need a word from you. We need to hear from heaven. God, I pray right now that the way you gave it to me, allow me to give it to the people. Send the rain. Send your power. Send your anointing. In Jesus' name we do pray. Amen. And thank God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Gifts that God has given our youth, and not ashamed to stand before God's people and use it. Amen. Today, it is a Christmas service, and we've been talking about leading up to the birth of Jesus all month long. And today, we're going to be in the Gospel of St. Luke, chapter 2. The Gospel of St. Luke, chapter 2. I'm going to read the first 15 verses. I know that's a lot, but we need to read it in its entirety. Luke chapter 2, verses 1 through 15. And the word of God says this: "And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And this taxing was first made when Serenius was governor of Syria. And all went to be taxed, everyone into his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and the lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being with great with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were so afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you: ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with an angel a multitude of heavenly hosts praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill towards men. And it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said one to another, Let us now go even unto Bethlehem and see this thing which has come to pass, which the Lord has made known unto us. Amen. Amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. I know that was a lot of reading, but I just love to read that passage. There's something about hearing it. Amen. I want to use for a subject today, delivering the gift. Delivering the gift. We've been dealing with this gift the last two Sundays. We talked about you are the gift. Now today we're dealing with delivering the gift. The world has commercialized Christmas.
Yeah, yeah.
It's all about the material gift.
Yeah.
It's about the Christmas tree. It's about Santa Claus, the decoration. But how do you know commercials, they've taken Jesus. You don't see in the commercials talking about Jesus when they mention the Christmas season. And he's the reason for the season. At work, we can't say Christmas party. We have to say holiday party because they don't want you to talk about Christ. They've tried to take Christ out of everything in reference to Christmas. But can I tell you, Christmas without Christ is like cheese with no macaroni.
Yeah.
It's like the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air with no Will Smith. It's like the Walker, Texas Ranger, amen, without Walker, Texas. You cannot have Christmas without Christ. You can have gifts all around the tree, piled up to the ceiling, but if you do not have Christ, you can't have a Merry Christmas. In the text today, we have Caesar Augustus. And he has made a decree that all the world should be taxed. Everybody got to come pay their taxes. And Mary and Joseph, they leave Nazareth, go to the city called David, Bethlehem, to pay their taxes. It is a 100-mile walk, or for Mary, a 100-mile donkey ride to Bethlehem. And Mary is in her third trimester, which means she's about to deliver. It's time for her to give birth to this gift. It's time for her to give birth to this baby. And I can't put a period, I gotta put a comma there, because there's somebody in here today. You're in your third trimester. And I came to tell you it's time to deliver. You've been having some labor pains. People can see it all over. You just show it. And it is time for you to deliver that thing. You look like you're pregnant. You don't feel the same. Your walk is a little different because you're carrying that baby. And it's time to deliver.
Fix it, Reverend. Fix it.
The gift got you looking different.
Yeah.
Got you walking different.
Yeah.
And you don't want to be bothered with certain people because a pregnant woman, when they pregnant, they just don't mess with me right now. Because there's something in you saying it's time to push this baby out. Can you imagine being in your third trimester? Your feet are swollen. Your body's in pain. Can't get around like you used to. And you got to ride an animal for 100 miles. Some of y'all complain just riding a car somewhere. She had to ride an animal for 100 miles to get to their destination. That would cause one to want to give up. But Mary did not give up because she had Jesus on the inside of her. And we ought to have that same mindset that no matter how hard life gets, no matter how hard the winds blow, no matter how much the thunder may lighten, no matter how much the lightning may flash, we can because we got Jesus on the inside of us. Behold, they shall call his name Emmanuel. God with us. God is with you. And that's enough for you to be able to push through your situation. Because all of these people have come to Bethlehem. It says that there's nowhere to stay. The text says there's no room for them in the inn. Now, I can understand the inn not having any rooms. But the problem I have is that they were so full that they didn't make room for Jesus. Mary is 9 months pregnant. They could have at least made a cot for her in the foyer of the hotel room. But it says that there was no room for Jesus. And they placed them in a stable, placed them in a barn. Now somebody may be saying, how could they treat Mary like that? How could they treat baby Jesus like that? But I want to let you know we treat him just like, treat Jesus like that as well.
Yeah, yeah.
We don't make room for him.
Yeah.
We get a paper cut, that's a reason for us not to come to church.
Yeah.
But yet on Monday morning we're going to be at work on time.
Yeah.
We find every excuse on why we can't serve Jesus. We don't make room for him. Some of us, we are so full that we don't have any room for the Savior. Full of hate, full of lust, full of backbiting, full of excuses, full of the love of the world, that we don't have room for Jesus. Because there was no room for them. She finds herself in a stable. Find herself in a barn for the whole night. And while she's there, she gives birth to Jesus. And I need to say it again. She gives birth to Jesus in a barn, in a stable. Now, I don't know if I can say it this way. Because you're gifted doesn't mean you're going to give birth to your gift on the stage of thousands of people. Because you're gifted don't mean you're going to give birth making millions of dollars as soon as you push that baby out. Because you're gifted doesn't mean that you're going to have a lot of people following you on Facebook and liking you and doing all of those things because you are gifted. Jesus was born in a manger. Humble beginnings. A manger was a food trough. A place where they fed pigs and horses and cows. Jesus was placed in a food trough where animals, where they ate. For a woman in here, can you imagine placing your child in a place where nasty animals have eaten out of? But not only that, they wrapped them in some pieces of clothes. Didn't even have a onesie to put on Jesus. Laid him in a food trough. And I'm sure this was an inconvenience for Mary. But she inconvenienced herself that the world might see Jesus. You need to know when you serve Jesus, sometimes it's going to feel like an inconvenience. Sometimes you're going to feel like you're by yourself. Sometimes it's going to feel like nobody cares. Sometimes you're going to get so tired that you're going to want to throw in the towel. But you got to give birth to that baby. You got to deliver what God has placed on the inside of you. It doesn't feel good for those that are here at Gen 11. You got to get up early in the morning and open up the church and make sure the heat is on and nobody really pats you on the back and tell you thank you. It doesn't feel good, ministers of music and praise team, when you're here, you're laboring on the weekend, you're getting ready, you're practicing, you're perfecting your gift, and you get here and you're praising God, nobody stands up and praise and worship with you. It doesn't feel good when you go to work and you work yourself to death and nobody says thank you for your hard work and your labor and your dedication, never get a pay raise, never get any rewards on your job. It does not feel good. But if you can remember the why behind what you're doing, that everything we do it unto God and not unto man. It doesn't matter if they don't pat you on the back. It doesn't matter if you never get a thank you. It doesn't matter if you never get any recognition. We serve a God who sees all and he knows all. Your labor is not in vain. Mary gives birth in spite of her circumstances. I came to tell somebody, don't let your circumstances stop you from giving birth to what God has placed inside of you. We make all kinds of excuses on why we can't do what God wants us to do. If I had more money, I could do it. If I didn't have these issues, I could do it. If I didn't have a past, if everybody didn't know what I did 20 years ago, I really could do this thing. But I thank God because of who he allowed to deliver the Savior of the world. Mary, a lonely peasant girl. Joseph, his earthly father, was a carpenter from the slums of Galilee. He was born in a food trough, wrapped in rags. And I believe God was telling us something through this message. Despise not the day of your small beginnings. That baby got to grow on the inside of you. It's a process. It may not look like anything right now, but keep on pushing. This morning, Lord, he began to speak to me. He said, this is the year of maximizing what I already gave you. It doesn't not yet appear what it shall be. But if you use what I gave you, if you keep on pushing, if you keep on pressing, God said, I'm going to work that thing out for you. What it shall be manifested. But you got to push that baby out. You got to keep on pushing. I was having a pity party. The reason why he was talking to me this morning, I was telling God, God, I'm so tired. I work 7 days a week. I'm always trying to help people. When they call my name, I say, hi, hi. I'm always there for everybody, and I'm just worn out. Don't feel like getting up this morning. And he began to tell me, he said, I've given you everything you need to deliver the baby. Yeah. Yeah. And I said, God, where is it? He says, all you got to do is ask for it.
Yes, sir. Yes,
you have not because you asked not.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
He says, when a woman is in labor, she's in the labor delivery room. She got people around her to help her deliver the baby. She got doctors. She got nurses. She got the OB tech. The anesthesiologist was there, come before and after. She got people to help her push that baby out. There are gifted people around her using their gift to help her to push out her gift.
Amen.
I got to say that again.
Amen.
That there are gifted people around her using their gift to help her push out her gift.
Yeah.
Where God is taking you,
yeah,
you can't do it by yourself.
Yeah.
Because the vision is too big. The gift is too big. You need a team of folk around you to help you to push that thing. You need some connections when you feel like giving up. They say, push, baby. Keep on pushing. I'm here to help you. I'll hold your hand when you want to go into town. You need a team around you to say, hold on, just rest a little while right now. Now push. I see the contraction. It's time to push. You need some people. I say, Lord, send you the right people. People with the right motives. Send you, connect you with some people that don't have any agendas. That's going to be there for you and not trying to use their agenda to. Matter of fact, I need some help, y'all.
Hey.
He said, you have not because you ask. Now, I need some help. This thing is too big for me.
Yeah.
I need somebody to come open up the doors of the church. I need somebody to turn the heat on. I need somebody to set up the chairs. I need somebody to run the multimedia section. I need somebody to get on Facebook and run that. We need some help here. Because I can't do it by myself. It says everything you need, he's giving it to you to give birth to that baby. But you just got to connect. You got to ask. You got to open your mouth. He said you got somebody to help you deliver it. Mary gives birth, and it says in the same country, shepherds were abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night.
Yeah.
And an angel of the Lord appeared before them, and it said the shepherds were afraid. The angel said unto them, fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. When I read this, I was confused. Why did the angels give this news to shepherds? A king is born. Why didn't they appear before religious leaders? Why did they not appear before the high priests or the scribes, people of status, people in Jerusalem? Because shepherds were the lowest of the low. Nobody wanted to be a shepherd. The occupation was dirty. It was for the outcast. They lived with sheep. Therefore, they stuck. Shepherds were called dirt people, common folk. They were not of the ruling class, but the angels came saying in their midst, I got some good news for you. And I have to ask the question, But he gave them the first invitation. Go and see this man. Go and see Jesus. And the Bible said they went to see Jesus. And that's the message we should give the world. Come and see Jesus just as you are. You ain't got to get rid of the stuff. You ain't got to get rid of the dirt. Just go and see Jesus. Weary, wounded, and sad. Bring your problems to Jesus. Bring your issues to Jesus. Bring your hurt and your pain to Jesus. Let's go to Bethlehem.
Preaching.
It said the angels, they began to praise and worship God. They began to rejoice. And all of us today, we got a reason to celebrate Jesus. Because he is the reason for the season. Somebody asked the question, what is the importance of Christmas? Can I tell you, it's all about Jesus. God got tired of sacrificing turtle doves. Got tired of us sacrificing on the Day of Atonement every year. He looked down through history. He tried to use Moses, but Moses had problems. He tried to use David, but David had problems. He tried to use Solomon, but Solomon had problems. He tried to use Noah, but Noah had problems. He said, I can't use anybody down here on earth. So he looked around heaven. Jesus has sent me out. Jesus came down through 42 generations, born of a virgin Mary, wrapped them in swaddling clothes. They found my Savior at the age of 12 in the temple, saying, I must be about my Father's business. They found him at the Jordan River, and God said, this is my Son in whom I am well pleased. They found him in the Garden of Gethsemane, saying, not my will, but thy will be done. And I'm thankful for Jesus, because that's not how the story is. They marched up on Judgment Hall to Judgment Hall. And Pilate said, what shall I do with this just man? They cried, crucify him, crucify him, crucify him. They marched up on a hill called Calvary. They put some nails in his hand. Not one hand, but two hands. They put a nail in his feet. And they raised him high above the earth. Oh, they dropped him in that hole. Can you imagine the pain, the agony that our Savior went through? Oh, and he said, forgive them, for they know not what they do. And he dropped his head in the knot of his shoulder. And he gave up the ghost. But I thank God that's not how the story is. They laid him in a bar or two. And he stayed there all Friday night. He stayed there all Saturday morning. He stayed there all Saturday night. But early Sunday morning, he got up. That was some power. That was light power. Tell somebody, you can deliver that baby. You can push that baby. Because he got up. All of my fears go. Because he got up. I can face tomorrow. You got to deliver that baby. You got to deliver that baby. God has something of you to do. He has a need of you. Ah. Listen. God gives gifts to profit the body, not to profit you. A tree does not eat its own fruit, but he gives off so that somebody else can be a blessing. And I came to tell you, God has given all of us a gift. He's given us all something to do. Give birth to that gift. The kingdom needs you. The kingdom desires to use your gift. Use it for his glory. Deliver the gift. Deliver the gift. Oh, God. Brother Tredarius, I'm going to ask you to come forth and give our closing prayer. Deliver the gift. If you don't remember anything I said today, Mary gave birth to the gift. that it will be a blessing to the nation. Push. Don't sit on it. Don't sit on it. Whatever he's telling you to do, he said, I've given you what you need to deliver that thing. But you got to deliver and push it.
Jesus, who you send in the earth, oh God. Oh God, I thank you for being a savior. God, I thank you for being a healer. God, I thank you for being a way maker. Oh God, right now I ask that you touch, oh God. Move by your mighty, move by your spirit. Oh God, we call on your name, which is Jesus. The only name we know what to call on. Hallelujah, Jesus. Oh Father, we ask God that you touch this ministry, oh God. God, be a blessing to this ministry, oh God, as they be blessings to others, oh God. Right now, God, ask that you touch every individual, oh God, that's here today, God. God, meet them at their knees, oh God. Every need, God. Every trouble they're going through, God, deliver them. Hallelujah, Jesus. Deliver them, God, out of the hands of the enemy, God. Oh God, we bless you. We praise you, oh God. We thank you once again, oh Father. Right now, God, don't see about our families, oh God. Cover them with your shedding blood, hide behind the cross, oh God. Now go rest their spirits, God. They need saving, God. They need healing, God. They need deliverance, oh God. Go rest their spirits right now, Father. Make them come back unto you, oh God. Oh God, we thank you. God, we repent of our sins, oh God. We turn away from our wicked ways, oh God. We run back to you, oh God. Because you are our healer. You are our deliverer. Bless you. I lift you up, oh God. Arrest our spirits, oh God. Move in our homes, move in our church, move in our jobs, oh God. Touch the man of God as he continues to do the will of God. Cover him in your shedded blood, oh God. Hide him behind the cross. Oh God, we love you. We thank you. And God, we ask all these things in your son Jesus' name. And all the people of God said, amen, amen, amen.
Thank you, Brother Jadaris, for that anointed prayer. The invitation is here for salvation before we close out. If you don't know Jesus as Lord and Savior, we ask that you give your life to him right now. If you don't know him, the pardon of your sins. We ask that you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus. Say, God, I know that I'm a sinner. I know I don't have it all together. I know I've missed the mark. I know I've fallen short of your glory. But I believe that your son, Jesus Christ, died for my sins. He says, if you do that, salvation can be yours today. And I believe if you truly mean that in your heart, you're saved. Father God, I pray for those that are watching us live, those that are here today, to say, I want to get my life together, but I need your Holy Spirit to reign and rule in me, because I can't do this by myself. I need you. God, I pray for that person. They will step out of faith, walk according to the way, God, you call on them to walk. That they will connect with a ministry, connect with people that's going to encourage them, it's going to push them, it's going to connect with them, and tell them to be about their Father's business. I pray for them right now. In Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah. take a seat.
Hello again, I'm back. So for our online gift, we have winners for that. What happened, you posted on our page, or I saw that you were viewing. Everybody's name on a raffle wheel, we spun the wheel. So our winners for our $50 Amazon gift card, Ms. Shatunda Howard. For our Apple Watch, Brittany Let Hurry. And for our 32-inch TV, Katrina Dean. So your name can be posted on our Facebook page and get in contact with us if you pick up those gifts or we can mail them to you. But thank you so much again. Thank you for viewing. Greater love. We love you. Thank you. Yeah.
One last thing. I was just told somebody want to give a testimony. Sister Brenda, come forth, come forth. Amen. We're not gonna hold you too much longer, but if somebody want to testify, we're gonna let them testify. Speak of the goodness of Jesus. God been good to anybody in here today. Brought you over, brought you through some stuff. We're thankful. Thankful for Jesus Christ. Amen. Stand to your feet. Listen, I am ecstatic. I'm thankful for all of you. After all of you be saved. This week we had to put masks on our kids. I know you can barely hear, but we wanted them to be saved as well. And I know some people watching them, like, y'all got all them kids on that stage together. That ain't 6 feet distance and all that. But we just believe God. We try to do things safe, try to do things in order, but be safe out there. Amen. Continue to wear your mask. Continue to use your hand sanitizer. Continue to stay at home if you don't have to go anywhere. Amen. We're going to get through this. Amen. But we refuse to let coronavirus to be the Grinch that stole Christmas. Amen. So I thank God for all of you that are here, everybody who's watching this live. Thank you for joining us. Look at your neighbor, say, neighbor, I love you. And there's nothing you can do about it. Look at another neighbor, say, neighbor, I love you. And there's nothing you can do about it. Amen. For those that are here, if you want to give on your way out the door, amen.